Mary had a little lamb. Sure, but what if she also had cows, chickens, and pigs? 28 animals in total, following her everywhere she went. Her life would be a little less rosy and have a little more manure and trampled land. We take up a lot of space on our own. 7 billion living human bodies weighing in at 125 million metric tons puts a lot of stress on the planet. And that's just us. But everywhere that humans go, we bring our cattle and chicken and sheep and pigs with us. And together, we're crowding wildlife off the planet. Meat production is the greatest threat to biodiversity worldwide. We've created a human bovine complex that tramples habitat and spews greenhouse emissions and pollution at the expense of other creatures. So, how big of an expense? Well, if every human on the planet got on one side of a scale measuring dry weight, that's the 125 million metric tons I mentioned earlier, and every elephant on the planet got on the other side, we'd outweigh them by a factor of nearly 200. That's because elephant populations have plummeted by 90% over the last century, while human populations have ballooned by 300%. 300%! And it's not just elephants. If we piled every single vertebrate land animal on that scale, from bats to buffalo, we'd still outweigh them. But it gets worse, because all that livestock belongs on our side of the scale. After all, they're not a part of the natural landscape. Now we're tipping the scale at 425 million metric tons, compared to just 10 million metric tons for all wild land animals. There has never been another large land animal whose population has grown as much, as quickly, or with such devastating consequences for almost all other species. So what can you do? You're just one person and you don't really have 28 animals following you around everywhere, right? Probably not. But what you choose to put on your plate can help determine how many animals are raised and how they're raised each year. By choosing to eat less meat and urging food providers and policymakers to make plant-based options more available, you can help tackle livestock population growth. And by supporting policies such as voluntary access to contraception and reproductive health care, gender equality, and education, you can help tackle human population growth too. Last but not least, support conservation so we can save what's left for wildlife. Oh, and if you haven't already, like us on Facebook.